All the members of Korean pop sensation BTS will fulfill their mandatory military service. The boy band's label announced Monday the oldest member, Jin, will cancel his request for deferment and will start to serve as soon as his solo activities conclude at the end of October. The other members will follow suit. The seven-man group will reconvene in 2025. Entertainment news now. Filipino-American actor Lou Diamond Phillips returns to the series The Cleaning Lady, but this time as a director. ABS-CBN's Hollywood correspondent Yong Chavez tells us more.
Hey, it's Lou Diamond Phillips, LDP, with a big hello and a thank you to all the Filipino...
Lou Diamond Phillips returns to The Cleaning Lady, this time behind the camera as the director of the episode, The Brit. The film actor appeared with his daughter, Gracie Phillips, in the show's Season 1 episode titled Gabayan. The show features several other Filipino talents, including Marta Milan. Filipina filmmaker Marija Mora also returned as a director of its recent episode titled Bahala Na. Phillips happily shared that he cooked Filipino food for the Cleaning Lady cast and crew when he worked on the show.
Some of you may know that I appeared on the show as an actor once before. Had a wonderful time and so very proud that there's a show out there that's very Filipino-centric. And so I was even more excited to come back as a director. So that's what this announcement is all about. I direct an upcoming episode of The Cleaning Lady and had an incredible time doing it. So to be able to showcase and elevate and support so much Filipino talent was, a great privilege. As an OG, happy to do it, right?
Phillips is one of the few original Filipino actors who made it in Hollywood when representation for talents of color was very limited. He has been waving the flag for diversity and inclusion from the beginning.
To something like The Cleaning Lady, where once again we are seeing faces that we wouldn't expect to see on our television screens, and I can be, you know, part of what elevates them and brings their best work, you know, to the audiences. I mean, that means a lot, but we have to just continue the fight. We have to continue the climb.
Apart from acting, he has been making his mark as a director. His credits include directing episodes of popular TV shows like Prodigal Son, Fear the Walking Dead, and Longmire, where he also co-starred. The episode of The Cleaning Lady that Phillips directed premieres in the U.S. on October 17. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.
The Canadian province of Alberta opens its doors to more Filipino nurses as it signs a deal with the Philippines to help these healthcare workers get employment opportunities. Marjorie Carmona Newman has a story.
Amidst the shortage of healthcare workers, the Alberta government signed a memorandum of understanding with the Philippine government on the employment of Filipino nurses.
Last October 6, 2022, Premier Jason Kenney of the Alberta government and Undersecretary Patricia Ibon Kaunan of the Department of Migrant Workers signed a Philippine-Alberta Memorandum of Understanding on the recruitment of Filipino nurses. So ito pong MOU na ito will allow, first, the government-to-government recruitment of Filipino nurses from the Philippines. Second, it will provide financial assistance for the Filipino nurses in Alberta who would like to apply for the accreditation of their nursing licenses and who would like to undergo the nursing bridging program here in Alberta.
Under the MOU, Filipino nurses in Alberta who will undergo the assessment, education and training, and licensing process can apply for financial assistance of up to $15,000 from the province once the program is finalized. The government of Alberta has allocated a budget of $3.5 million for the bursary program. This Filipino who just obtained his nursing certification welcomes the new announcement.
Kasi mabibigyan ng maraming pagkakataon ang mga Filipino nurses na makapunta dito sa Alberta at makapag-practice kaagad bilang registered nurses. Kasi hindi ganun kadali na maging registered nurses dito sa Alberta. Pero kung magkakaroon ng paraan para mapapadali ang pagpunta nila dito bilang registered nurses, ay napakagandang balita nito.
Aris Clemente Listanan started applying to become a registered nurse in the province through the College of Registered Nurses in Alberta, or CARNA, in 2016. But it took him almost 5 years to obtain certification. Finally, he was able to complete all the requirements this year.
Matagal na proseso kasi bago pa ako pumunta dito sa Canada noong 2016, ay nagsimula na akong mag-submit o mag-submit nga ng mga dokumento sa College of Registered Nurses dito. Tapos naghintay ako ng maraming taon para lang matanggap sa eskwelahan na nagbibigay o nag-offer ng bridge to Canadian nursing.
We've been working with the government of the Philippines over the past several months to establish an agreement to make Alberta a preferred destination for inbound Filipino nurses who are in demand all around the world because of their remarkably high skill, their culture of compassion.
The MOU aims to promote the sound, ethical, and sustainable recruitment practice between the two countries. This includes collaboration in the areas of certification, recognition, and matching of skills and qualifications, and the provision of support to Filipino nurses who are not yet registered to practice in Alberta.
Maghihintay po muna tayo ng announcements ng Alberta government at saka po ng Philippine government kung paano po i-implement itong government-to-government recruitment, yung nursing bridging program sa Pilipinas, at saka po itong application for financial assistance. Lahat po ng mga Filipino nurses na interesado dito po sa MOU na to, na i-follow po ang Philippine Consulate General's Facebook page, Alberta government's website.
Negotiations with the government of Alberta were spearheaded by the Philippine Consulate General in Calgary and the Philippine Overseas Labor Office in Vancouver. Marjorie Carmona Newman, Edmonton, Alberta, Canada.